Hello and welcome back to Smoking Dragon Plays Mass Effect Andromeda. We're back here on the Nexus after getting involved with a quest where we either convict or find innocent a Turian that is accused of murder. He was part of the initial, landing party on some planet or something to that effect. I have to say right now, I am really feeling a part of this universe, this Mass Effect universe. Simply because I just got a cavity replaced in my mouth and they completely just numbed up my face. So my face kind of matches a lot of the ones you'll see in this game. It shows no emotion. I can't smile or really show any emotion at all. It's like I've gotten a bad case of Botox or something. So let's check this strike team mission, see what this is about before we talk to Kandros.
This console reports on the militia's current strike team missions, Pathfinder. Please speak with Tyrann Kandros for authorization to participate.
Alright, we have to talk to Kandros about a bunch of stuff, I guess. Alright, Kandros, what do you have for us?
That's the console for our strike teams.
What are they?
Assault and extraction squads. When we need the best, I have Apex, combat experts who've signed up to defend us. Since you have a front row view of the cluster, I can give you authority to dispatch them.
Dispatch them for what?
What situations should they handle?
Protecting civilian outposts, holding key positions, or just distracting the kit. Authorization complete. Good luck out there.
Alright. Let's inspect the available strike team missions. Oh, we have a bunch of them we can do. Let's see here. Strike teams can be sent on missions to support the Andromeda Initiative. If they succeed, they'll earn XP and Ryder will gain a reward. If they fail, they'll only earn a small XP and no special reward. Apex is the most elite strike team in the cluster and can handle critical missions. Select a mission and press space to send Apex. Your progress will automatically be saved before multiplayer is launched. You will then play the role of Apex operative in a small squad. Play Apex missions in multiplayer, either with friends or through public matchmaking, to earn strike team rewards for Ryder and additional bonuses. So this seems like a multiplayer type thing, obviously. I'll select one. I probably won't play it on camera. There's a lot of information here. But it sounds like you just select a mission and then you play it in multiplayer and you get a reward for it. Alright, so let's just pick an easy one for now, and I'll do it later. I don't want to play right now. I'll do this off camera, because I think if I select one, it'll instantly put me into multiplayer, so I'll check that out off camera. I'm not exactly sure how it works. But interesting, nonetheless. Alright, Kandros, what else do you have for us?
I know that look. The others bent your ear, did they?
Something like that?
You get used to it. Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results, though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Arc.
What's the word on the Turian Arc?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
Alright, let's talk about the murder case first.
I spoke with Nilkin Rensis, the man found guilty of the murder on Eos.
Yes, our first murder here in Andromeda. I wish it had been our last. When the colony attempts failed, it didn't help spirits that a high-ranking officer was killed by one of our own. The mutiny here on Nexus was probably inevitable, but this acted as a spark.
And he was found guilty.
So there was a trial, and he was found guilty?
It was short and decisive. Despite the lack of physical evidence, everything added up. His only defense was, trust me, I didn't mean to do it.
And you didn't trust him, or that matters?
That is the difference between murder and accidental death.
In this case, motive plus opportunity plus eyewitness account equals murder. Look, knock yourself out. A key witness, Cassidy Shaw, works in operations. Go ahead and talk to her. And there's a recording of the perpetrator threatening the victim. I'll let you queue it up on the console there. As far as I'm concerned, this case is closed.
Alright, let's talk about some other stuff. Coming to Andromeda.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations, you know. Then my sister became a sculptor and cousin Nyrene went pirate on Omega. Everyone was proud that I stayed in service. But I kept wondering, when do I get my adventure? Jen Garson's dream was so grand, so gutsy, I had to be part of it.
All right, what's your role?
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Kent found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards and headed back to warn the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
What's the welfare of the Turian people here?
Are the other Turians managing okay?
So-so. We're not good at sitting around in a crisis. Service before self gets drummed into us at boot camp. That's probably why so many of us are in the militia. We like to earn our citizenship, whatever galaxy we're in. But it's hard to focus with our arc missing.
Alright, tell me more about the Kett.
What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Kett?
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Kett don't take kindly to anyone studying them. Not sure why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
Alright, what's the militia's uses?
It's rough out there. I might need backup, if you can spare the people.
I have strike teams specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. But that isn't news to you, right?
I guess not. Alright, goodbye. I think that's all we need from him for right
now.
Duty
calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Let us check... Ooh, what's over here?
Please report to the Hyperion Coupling Annex.
Could have sworn I saw something pop up over here. Guess not. Let us check this data pad. Apex status. Based on the status report 16C, it seems we're no closer to gaining a foothold in any sector. Without decent recon and greater intel on this enemy, I'm starting to think our efforts are futile. The risks involved in continued loss of resources and lives make it hard to justify. With morale this low, we need to scale down expectations again. All right. Where is that console we have to check to find out more about the
technicians, please report to the Hyperion coupling
the prisoner. It looks like it's right here. So let's check the recording.
The Nexus versus colonist Nilkin, evidence 7A. Hiram! Hiram! They've seized the compound! Call for evacuation!
We're not giving up, Nilkin. We're taking it back!
No! I'm not letting your ego get us killed! Even if I have to...
No! Get him off me! Get him off me!
Alright, that sounds pretty damning to me. I'm ready to convict this guy. I think he did it. He's definitely guilty. We already talked with Liam in the last episode, so
you're in the forest?
I'm not going to talk to him again. We have to speak with Director Tann, but let's continue along with this prisoner side mission. So let's check the journal and see where we have to go to talk to the other eyewitness. Escape back. Additional tasks. Let's see. That's not it. Helios assignments. First murder. Okay, so, space. Toggle tracked. Okay, so we are tracking it, hopefully. Where is it? Up here, maybe? Let's see what we got up here. I know Director Tann's office is up here. I don't want to go there quite yet. Let's check the map real quick. Okay, so yeah, we're on the right track. Good! Alright. Okay, there it is. Alright. Cassidy Shaw, what did you see?
Cassidy Shaw? I'm Ryder. I'm looking into the Nilken murder case.
Oh man, I thought that was over with. Have you heard the audio recording of their fight?
Yes.
I helped pull him off Chief Reynolds. You could see it in his eyes. He was gonna kill him. Then in the sandstorm, I had a pretty clear view of the Chief. He looked right at Nilken and shouted, no. Then his chest burst open. I'll never forget it. The look on his face was pure shock.
Alright. Why was the Chief shocked?
If they'd fought and Nilken threatened to kill him, why was Reynolds surprised?
Friends fight, say things they don't mean, maybe even hurt each other. But you don't expect your best friend to shoot you. To me, that's the saddest part. The Chief's heart was broken right before it exploded.
Did Nilken regret it?
Did Nilken seem remorseful?
I lost sight of Nilken in the turmoil. When we found him, he seemed in shock. He couldn't speak. He looked nauseated. Could have been guilt. The reality of the act sinking in.
Were the Ket there?
Did you see any Ket in the vicinity?
Nilken said so, but not that I could see. Still, the sandstorm was severe. Visibility wasn't great.
And do you agree with the Chief?
Reynolds was leading you back to retake the compound. Did you agree with that?
It wasn't my place to agree or disagree. He was ranking officer. In retrospect, it is ironic. If he hadn't been killed, we all probably would have died.
All right, thank you.
I appreciate the information.
Of course. It kills me we had to leave him behind. He deserved a proper funeral.
So the body was never examined? Important piece of a murder investigation.
Tann wouldn't allow a mission to go back for him. Said it was too dangerous.
All right, so we have to talk with Tann to finish this one up. Before we do that, let's check the codex, because I know we have some more exclamation points pointing us to something we've discovered or not discovered. And hopefully we can tell which one it is. Let's see here. The militia. Okay, so this just tells us a little bit about the militia on the Nexus and the Apex that we kind of learned about doing those multiplayer missions. Let's learn about the Nexus. Tyrion Kandros, so we can see what is up with him and how he got started here, it looks like. And feel free to look at that on your own. And let's check our journal. And I think, we just have to speak with Tann. All right. What completed mission do we have? First strike. Okay, it's just the mission to acquire the mission. All right, so let's speak with Director Tann. We have a lot to talk about with him, apparently. Look at him jump down those stairs. He seems really happy about it. Look at me. All right, he didn't do it that time. You're gonna do it this time, Melvin. Don't make me look like an idiot. He did it first time. All right. Sorry. Let's check the map and go speak with Director Tann, wherever that is. Let's see here. Let's track the quest. All right. Does it show it now? Yep, there it is. All right.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
You trust me now?
I thought I didn't measure up as Pathfinder.
Director Addison keeps her own counsel. I keep mine.
And when you disagree?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself. To that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the Golden Worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable. So how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right. I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
Don't play games with me, Director Tann.
The way I see it, you need me. If I pull this off, maybe you'll look like the leader you pretend to be.
But first, you have to succeed at being the Pathfinder you pretend to be.
Touché. Where's my ship?
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for EOS will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about that.
Something wrong?
Ryder, please see me and Sam Nude on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No, I'm fine.
Alright. We got a lot of updates to our codex, but let's continue talking with Director Tann.
Ryder, you may have a less than flattering view of me, but I want to express my condolences for your father.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
What happened to him, anyway?
Any idea where they went?
Nothing certain. But tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
Yeah, the Nilkin murder charge. I want to know more about that.
I'm looking into the Nilkin Rensis murder charge.
And?
I want to go to EOS and retrieve Chief Reynolds' body.
That isn't usually Pathfinder business.
First murder in Andromeda, and I'm impartial. Figured you'd want to get it right.
Settling an outpost comes first. But I suppose I have no objections. Physical evidence will only bolster the case.
Body can reveal much.
The more certain we can be, the better.
All right, but let's keep it quiet. I don't want people thinking we're reopening the case. I hope anything you find reaffirms what's been done, but if it sheds a different light, we'll deal with it. We'll send the coordinates of the murder scene. Good luck.
All right, let's talk more about the Nexus troubles.
It sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly, I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you, it's been a disaster. The Scourge killed hundreds, many of them our senior leadership. Even the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, is dead.
Yeah, tell me more about that.
How did Gian Garson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit the Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Gian Garson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
Wow, that's a little depressing. Tell me more about this disaster. How did it happen?
Kandris mentioned something about hitting the Scourge. How did it play out?
Criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's fears. An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny and the criminals were banished. Exiles, we called them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane Kelly. She used to be one of ours.
All right, tell me more about Sloane.
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined them. Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen? Nonsense. They posed a direct threat to our existence.
And where are the Krogan now?
There don't seem to be many Krogan around.
Good riddance. The Krogan demanded a greater say in political matters. The last place you want them involved. Their muscle, nothing more. Good for fighting and lifting heavy objects. When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
Why do you dislike the Krogan so much?
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst instincts. What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda? We'll all be dead.
All right, that was a long bit of exposition there, so let's continue along. The Andromeda Initiative, how's that going? Not well.
What more can you tell me about the Initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
Oh, how did it, what was the origin of it?
What do you know about the early days of the Initiative?
As most everyone knows, Gian Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the Initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
What are your motivations for coming? I assume that's what that means.
Why do you think most people came?
No.
There are thousands of reasons. One for every colonist here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness. Finding the thing that eludes them. The thing to fulfill them. While we cannot promise they will find it, we can facilitate the search.
And what about the alien species on the Nexus?
It looks like a melting pot around here.
The Nexus is home to several Initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arks. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix. As a Solarian, my kind tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
Alright, tell me about something else. Any other questions I have? Okay. What's your role in all this?
As director of the Initiative, are you in charge around here or what?
If the others would allow me, they don't see me as the rightful successor.
Is there a gridlock?
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
Why the doubt?
What's their problem with you?
I am not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic. She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles, some never made it out of stasis. I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died. I was next in line for the role.
Revenue management?
So, you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know. When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours, and I went a different direction. Then I heard about the Initiative, and saw my chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry.
All right. What else do we have? The missing Arks.
Any more information you can give me on the missing Arks?
No. And that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Solarian Arks are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst. Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other Arks, the promise of the Initiative can never be fulfilled.
Additional Arks?
Are there any other Arks we should expect?
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave. But before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time to come.
All right, that sounds like DLC right there. All right, planet viability.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to eliminate any hostile threats. Whether that's the cat, or other terrors lurking in Helios, colonists being murdered on site can be discouraging. Also, scouting and mapping terrain is a priority for any Pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations. You'll want those.
What are forward stations?
What can you tell me about forward stations?
I was afraid you'd ask. It's mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, it's just theory at the moment. You get to test it out, Ryder.
Oh boy, sounds exciting. All right, that's all I need from you for right now, Director Tann. Goodbye.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
Of course. As you pointed out, we need each other. Our futures depend on each other's success.
All right, we completed the task. Is there anything else we can do here? All right, so we have to speak with Sam on the Hyperion. And let's see here. Before I do that, let me check my codex real quick and see what we learned. But Nexus... we learned about Director Tann, which nobody really seems to like. He's even more disliked than Commander Addison, which I really don't like Commander Addison. and then the planets and locations. Learned about the Scourge. So feel free to take a look at that. I'll do it on my own. And anything else? Yes, something else. Ships and vehicles. The Ark Pacino. That sounds about right. Ark Pacino. So they like to play Pacino on here. And this is for the... let's just find out who's in this one. Solarian. And the Ark Lucina. For the... Asari. And then I guess this is for the Turian. The Ark Nautilus. That sounds about right. Good name for an Ark. That's what I'm going to call it anyway. And, alright. No other codexes. And, let's check our journal. We have to speak with Sam. Do we have any other side missions? Find out about the, different arcs. Okay, so we'll probably do that as we go along, and then we have to, I guess, investigate Eos for the murderer. I really just want to convict him right now and be done with it. Like I said, I'm playing a jerk in this mission. Alright, well, that seems like a good place to end the episode here. Yeah, my face is starting to return to normal, so that's good. It doesn't feel like it's part of the game anymore. It's actually, I can have a little bit more expression now. And I guess I'll see you guys on the next episode. Thanks for watching.